I pray that you as a mom and a dad will always remember to never, never, never give your children negative labels. Whatever label goes on a child's forehead, that's exactly the reputation they'll fulfill. My wife and I have two married sons. We enjoy the grandkids. We enjoy our sons and daughters-in-law. And I, by God's grace, never planned to fully retire. I enjoy helping people. I have a successful counseling practice in Carmel, Indiana. And by God's grace, I pray for a healthy mind and a healthy body. And I pray that I can serve the Lord and help others through my counseling practice and through my writing, teaching, speaking, hopefully until I'm 90. I was a Lutheran high school teacher for 8 years. I have a master's degree in education administration, was an assistant principal and athletic director. I actually had high school football and basketball coach, and so got my expertise there. But one of the things I say in my book is my wife and I made mistakes as parents, and we wish we had do-overs with some of our parenting words and behaviors. I mean, we were not perfect parents either. There's no perfect parent. There's no perfect child. The key, though, is to have the knowledge and the skills. A lot of these principles we tried, or these simple habits, simple yet effective habits, after our boys were older, and probably I would say from 1995 till now, the last 26 years of helping parents, is where I kind of fine-tune what makes a difference. And that's why I wrote my Simple Habits for Effective Parenting that's published. One of the keys, I think, for every parent to keep in mind, and I pray, I've shared a few things with you, but I pray that you as a mom and a dad will always remember to never, never, never give your children negative labels. Whatever label goes on a child's forehead, that's exactly the reputation they'll fulfill. So if a parent says to their, out of frustration for something a child is doing, you are obnoxious. Well, what's the child going to become? Obnoxious. You are lazy. They'll become lazy. You are disorganized. They'll become disorganized. Children, whatever negative label is given, as well as whatever positive label is given, children will fulfill those labels. And so it's absolutely essential that parents never give a negative label and only give positive labels. Now, some parents have said, well, Dr. Schroeder, you are asking me to manipulate my child, and I'm not asking you to do that. I would never do that as a pastor. But I do want you to influence your child in a positive direction and identify those qualities that you want in your child, certainly the fruit of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. Those are all positive labels that parents can appreciate. And I actually call it an appreciation vitamin, to say, I appreciate your kindness. I appreciate your hard work. I appreciate your helpfulness. I appreciate your determination. Whatever label, again, a parent puts on their child's forehead, that's what they'll become. And I have seen that benefit parents and children over and over and over. I had a mom who brought their 7-year-old daughter to see me, and in front of the daughter, actually shared a negative label, said, Dr. Schroeder, our daughter is extremely shy. Negative label. And social skills are important. I'm not being critical of the daughter being shy, but she said, we want her to not be so shy and to develop some good communication skills and socially interact with others. And the little girl, I asked her a few questions, and she spoke very well. And I said, you know, you communicate very well. May I call you Miss Talker? And the little girl smiled and said, sure. And so I got with Mom in private, had the little girl wait in the lobby, and I said, Mom, you and Dad, whenever she talks, don't use insincerity and flattery. Whenever your daughter talks, will you please give her a positive label? I appreciate you're a good talker. And then also go to school. You know, when she speaks up, Maybe when she raises her hand in the classroom and talks, have the teacher use the I appreciate. Again, that vitamin, appreciate lifts self-worth and self-esteem. Appreciate is praise. Praise creates positive energy in every child. And so have the teacher say, I appreciate that you were a good talker today. You know, and I appreciate you talking to your friends at recess, whatever it is. And every time mom would bring her daughter to counseling, I always would say, mom and Miss Talker, I gave her that positive label, come on back. And then mom and Miss Talker would come back to the counseling session. And after about 6 or 7 months, what do you think that little girl became? You're exactly right. She fulfilled the reputation, Miss Talker. She became a good communicator. Now, I gave her some other skills as well to help her out. But what really made a difference is mom and dad catching their daughter being a talker. Again, don't use flattery. Caught her daughter being, their daughter being a talker and said, we appreciate how well you're talking, how well you're communicating, and she became a talker. And so those are just some ideas on my Simple Habits for Effective Parenting book that I want to share with you right now just to help you see that it's simple yet effective habits. But it's got to be specifics. It can't be generalities, concepts, and terms. That does really not benefit relationships immensely as it does having specific skills and tools.